a whirly launcher thing, majig. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Coldborough Farm. Today, I'm going to follow what you guys said in the last poll. So we had 32 responses, which is quite a lot. I'm not going to beat about the bush. Silage won with 81% of the vote. Almost everybody, in fact, six people didn't vote for Silage. And those six were bizarrely spread across the other three options. One of which was Ford saying other as usual. So, without further ado, I have had to cheat a small bit and got rid of the... I had to get rid of the loan. I had to set the loan to zero. I'll set it back up to like 200,000 after this. So, let's get some renting done. So, we're gonna need the kid, because we don't have the field mode. We're gonna need the QM16 silage edition, which should be over here. We'll rent that. And that's it, really. Now, I'm gonna use follow me, which I usually don't, but hey. Let's do it anyway. There's the Ford is there. Awesome. Let's get this running. Got the volume down a bit too low. There we go. So let's detangle myself from the wires. Let us take off the loader bracket. I did do as much mowing as I possibly could. All the fields have the edges mowed now. And I may or may not have cheated the X mark a bit to like a capacity of, I think, 450,000, which is impossibly huge. But that's what I cheated it up to, because I'm a cheaty pants. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually just reset the stuff, because I think the Massey's over at Yatton Ridge. And it is. So we'll reset that, because we're going to need it. Reset the kid. And we'll reset the QM16. Just get them all delivered down here. And why is it still showing there's a... That better not be... Oh, good. See Oliver. Awesome. So we are going to be doing silage with the QM16 and the kid. So today, I know that on... Little Town, I had Ford on the kids, so we're gonna have this on our silage trailer. We're gonna have the Massey here, which is insanely loud, so deal with it. We're gonna have this on the kid. And don't worry, I know what I'm doing for once. Those of you who are in the streams will know what exactly I'm doing. Load up here. Should the PTO attached? Is the PTO attached? Yes. So let's move the Massey up to the gate here. Awesome. Let's grab the Ford and hit right control F. And that should now be on follow me. A distance of about 5 meters. Okay, 5 is too close. 10 will do. So we're going to bring these down to the field. And I'll catch up with you guys down there. I'm going to turn on track hat while I'm on my way. There we go. So the Ford's going to follow us down. Let's get our beacon on. There's only the Massey has the beacon, unfortunately, so we're going to lead this little convoy. It is a little convoy. What I decided to do, because I'm going to boost the loan back up, is I am going to bring all the silage into the BGA. And what I'll do is I'll silage up the grass over at Yatton Ridge for the pigs. Now, next week's options. While I'm on my way down, I can take care of all this little menial work. Next week's options. Option number one is the most blatant one, seeing as I'm bringing the silage over to the BGA and planning on fast-forwarding through the night. Option number one is selling the silage. So we can get lots and lots of money next week. And I'll do it manually on video, and then once we get into the streams, I'll just have Course play set up to do it. Because I'm not going to do that all manually, especially if we've got quite a lot of silage. Option number two is going to be harvesting, because we're going to have crops that are going to need harvesting. It only makes sense to get them done. And option number three is going to be mowing at Chantry Farm, which means we'll be mowing for hay. Chantry is going to be our dedicated hay farm. Yatton Ridge is going to be our dedicated silage farm. So option three is specifically mowing at Chantry. I would have an option for mowing at Yatton Ridge, but I don't want to do silage cutting two videos in a row. That's the long and the short of it. So I will be moving the forward to a better position once we're actually in the field. The better position in terms of get it to one side of the harvester. So we're almost there now. There's no real point in me just advancing time. Is it still behind us? Yes, and it's going insanely slowly. Why is it going very slowly? Is it struggling? Am I causing issues? I probably am causing issues. But in real life, I have seen like videos. Of course, you wouldn't have a hot pink Massey Ferguson with John Deere stickers on it. But in real life, you would see something like this set up with a 698 or something pulling the kid. And the Ford has got stuck. A 698 or something of a similar size pulling a kid. And something like a TW10 or TW15 or maybe even a 25 pulling a silage trailer. So let's get this off. Follow me for a second. Let's get this off. Follow me. And just rectify this situation. There we go. We'll hop back into the Massey and head off again. And, ooh! This appears to be a slightly earlier version of my edit for some reason. Which could easily mean I am using the wrong version of the map. I am. Nuts. It means I gotta go in through field 32, doesn't it? Where did I... Okay, I'll cut back when I'm actually after finding the entrance to the field. It should be over here somewhere. Is it over here? Ooh, buggeration, Dave. You made a right mess of this, didn't you? Found the entrance. It's inexplicably up here. Which means I'm going to have to pull out of the road. And... Oh, dang it. Well, this is going to be fun, isn't it? So we can use this meadow up here to turn around, which is awesome. Because we now need to turn around. Please don't get stuck on anything forward. Thank you very much. It would appear I've got the wrong version of my edit in, which is a bit of a shame. I'll rectify that. This is both an earlier and a newer version simultaneously. It's Schrodinger's edit. You're just hoping the Ford doesn't get stuck on something. Ford didn't get stuck on something. Awesome. So we need to go down over here to this entrance, which is actually kind of handy in a way. Many ways it's not, but in a way it's handy because it's closer to the BGA. Now, I probably should have actually put a gated entrance like right next to Field 32. In hindsight, I probably should have done that, but I didn't, so. Hindsight's 20/20, kids. Are you stuck, or are you just... Okay, you're just faffing about in the gateway. Awesome. So close the gate. We spent almost a full third of this video just getting to the field. Alright, Oh, that's not gonna work, is it? With the Ford, so... I need to... Oh, dang. I may have done something incredibly stupid here. So that's that in. We'll stop the Ford immediately. Just so it doesn't get stuck. And we'll take control and bring it in on a wider arc, because the straighter's a lot longer than the kid. That I didn't leave enough room for the trailer. Let's unfold the kid right now while we're there. And the trailer is in fact stuck. Let's have it offset. So this is just going to cause problems. Yeah, ignore that, please. Ignore all of that. Can I change the sides? No, so it has to be... Realistically, it has to be on this side of the kid. Which is fine, I guess. That's going to cause issues, though. So we park the Ford there like that. Up back into their Massey here. The Fergie. And... bring it around, because it has to be ahead of the Ford for the Ford to pick up a trace from it. That should be enough. Control F. Nope. So we'll just reverse this back a bit. Control F. Head. No. 5 meters to the right, please. And that should be it. Good. Activate the kid, and off we go. Okay, 4 meters to the left. Oh my god, immediately stuck. Here's why I don't use follow me that much. Unable to locate a nearby trail within viewing range. Alright, so is that going in? That is going in to the trailer. Albeit slowly, it is going in. Don't know quite how much silage we're going to get, but I'm hoping for a decent amount. Why is... Huh. Well, I've got some sort of bug going on here, don't I? What on earth? Oh, I had IC on. Well, there's your problem. I can even get this to 3.5 meters on offset, I think. That looks about right. So what we're going to do is we're going to hop into the Ferguson, the John Ferguson here, and very carefully and deliberately drive around. Can I get this actually slightly forward of it? That's much better. I know it doesn't look great, but it's the best I can do. Oh yes, I remember that tree now. That's back collisions. So what we'll be doing in the streams this week, is this field effectively, and hopefully getting fast forwarded to the point where we can start harvesting. And what I'll do after that is I'll actually re-edit the map to put a couple of new crops in. And also, this is going to come as a surprise to some people, because it's the exact opposite of what I did to begin with. I'm going to disable soil mod and re-enable Gill Mist. I'm going to speed this map up. So after this next harvest, soil mod will be gone. While it's a lot of fun to have the problem solving involved in soil mod, it slows the map down to the point where you're hardly making any progress. Well, that's the way I like to play. It's not particularly good for YouTube, so I'm gonna effectively revert the map. I might just make the same edits on a new download, because getting Seed Master etc. in, really easy. Getting rid of Soil Mod, not so easy. So I might just re-download the map, re-edit it up, get the new crops in, and work from there. But soil mod after this harvest is done. Soil mod's going away. I love it. I think more maps should have it. Don't think it's good for YouTube. And I do like the fact that Gill Mist does add textures to stuff, so I'll probably retexture Gill Mist as well. Because I think there are Gillimist textures available. I know there are good textures for the crops I want to put in available. That's kind of a given. So the great thing about the kit is that he can double chop like this. Is this double chopping or is it single chopping? I'm not entirely sure, but it can mow. And that's why I absolutely loved it in 13, that's why I love it in 15, that's why I wanted it. It's very versatile. I mean, you saw in Little Town last week that you can pick up windrows with it, no problem at all. It is just a trailed forage harvester. What I'm showing off this week is the secondary kind of option of it, which is as a whole crop harvester, which is something you don't see much of in trailed versions. I mean, there's not a whole lot of trailed versions available of whole crop anything. Even, you know, normal combine harvesters, there's not that many trailed ones available. Because of soil mod, this yield is atrocious. Which doesn't exactly surprise me, but plus I'm just cutting grass into it. I am outputting as chaff. I could output as grass as well with this. That's kind of a third option, is if you're doing direct cutting, you can output as grass directly. But I kind of like chaffing it up. To put a realistic spin on it, it gives a more... it gives a better silage. It gives better fermentation in the silo. And it is quite easy to pole crop as well. So I'm just going to slow down to 10-ish kilometers an hour, because that's probably a more realistic speed. It's about 6 miles an hour to be doing this. And in reality, I know this, I've seen it. You could either attach it directly to the harvester, or you could have a secondary tractor pulling it. But the tractors that usually use this kind of stuff are quite old. I have seen a Renault Ares running a kid, a relatively new Renault Ares. I've seen quite a few 698s, a couple of Fords, and a couple of even older tractors still. I think I saw a 135 running it. I mean, it doesn't require a whole lot of power. It's effectively just a flail mower, and what is it? A flail mower, an auger to center it all up, and then just some vacuum launcher kind of thing. A whirly launcher thing, majig. And all I'm trying to say it is, but it's very difficult for me to explain. So that's all it is, because somebody managed to rust one out to the point where it was pretty much useless as a harvester, but it was a really good display model. Just to show how it worked, or they took a panel or two off and showed how it works. Which is really nice. It's nice to see that kind of stuff. I don't quite know if it'll double chop like this, but that's what I'm doing. Because it feels better to me outputting as chaff. So the Ford is just under a third full already. We've only done 3 or 4 rounds of the field and it's a third full. And yes, this doesn't have the biggest, you know, pickup in the world. It's not the greatest piece of equipment to be using for silaging, but it's the kind of thing that I would use if I was doing this in real life, and I, you know, would want to use something more like this over, we'll say, a Class Jaguar with a 300 pickup or whatever the pickup is. Or Class Jaguar. I would prefer to use this over a Big X. I would prefer to use this over a New Holland or a Rostelmash. Or even a John Deere 8600i. I would take the kid over an 8600i any day. So the TW10 is now, or the Marshall is now one third full. Which is good, I guess. The joy of this though is I can re-edit the loan after this to be 200,000 plus whatever the loan from this is, so I can just take a note of it and edit the loan up to the specific value I'll need. So that's a good thing. And now that I've said, by the way, that I will be editing Coldbrick to basically make it back to what it was originally a bit more, I kind of have to do it. Because number one, there've been a lot of complaints about, hey, this is taking forever. I'll be honest, I'm kind of bored of how long it's taking as well. I prefer to use the smaller equipment because I do like the smaller equipment, and just be able to go over it with a sprayer, get the tram lines in, and then say, hey, it's done, instead of having to go over it 6 times with a sprayer, twice with a fertilizer spreader, and all that kind of stuff. But I think I'm doing rather well with this setup here. So let's go out of cab and just zoom out of it so you can see. So we're just doing rounds because it's the easiest thing to do. We're picking up a nice, reasonable swath of, what, about 2 meters at a single go. It's probably not putting it all into the trailer, I will admit. And there's a decent chance we'll only get one trailer load out of this. We probably would have been better getting a JF and, you know, mowing this field and then picking up with a JF. Might have got more that way. Because I'm not certain, but I would like to think this thing simulates, you know, losses from the grass clumping up and getting stuck to the inside of the trailer and that kind of stuff. That'd be nice to think, at least. I'm not entirely sure how the Ford's figuring out where it needs to go here, but it's doing a pretty funky job of it. So let's just pull it back to 3.5 left offset. Have I re-enabled the mouse? Yes, I have. There we go. So, I mean, it is quite nice to see these two old... And they are quite old. They're from the, what, 80s and early 90s. Old tractors just doing their thing. With, granted, a relatively new trailer, but the kit isn't new by any means. You can still probably buy these new, but they're not new. It's not a new model. It's quite an old model from... I'd imagine the mid-90s or early 2000s. It's, you know, it's... not the most high-tech thing in the world. I wouldn't imagine many companies be building brand new trail foragers, put it that way. That said, I would love for there to be one in FS17. Absolutely love it. Because that's the kind of thing that I like using. Especially if it's, you know, capable of doing grass. I don't like... I'm gonna be honest, I don't like making corn silage at all. It just seems a bit too quick and easy. If I'm being blunt. Yeah, this... There's at least a bit of skill involved. You have to... Well, I know with grass it's actually slightly easier than corn silage because you don't have to seed it, but... Really, I mean, this is what you would see 90% of the time in Ireland, is grass getting silaged instead of corn getting silaged. I know there is maize silage being made around the country as well. And most contractors would windrow it up now. Yeah, they come out with, let's say, their coon mowers, coon triple mowers or double mowers, or their Cavernland mowers with the windrow capacity in them. Cut it, windrow it up, get out, usually, like, most of them are like class or chrome rakes. Rake them into decent piles and bring in a big X. Or a John Deere, or a, well, usually a Jaguar. The Jaguar is the most popular, that I've seen. But I have seen a big X on the go, I have seen big M on the go, you know, I've seen a lot of Corona equipment on the go. But the class Jaguar is by far the most popular forager around here. And then you've got the likes of the Big X, there's a few New Hollands, one or two John Deere's. It's not that common because the John Deere equipment tends to be quite large, a lot bigger than the Jaguar and the Big X, and even New Hollands, so you wouldn't see that too much. Then you got the guys who are a bit more traditionalistic. That I like. They use the likes of the JF Stahl, the Kid, and various other older pieces of equipment. Then you got the people up near Faye who just use the weirdest wonky looking crap. Like, he showed me a video the other day, and the forage harvester, it was a self-propelled harvester, and it literally had the pipe on the front. I'm not entirely sure why that was made, but the rear of it was literally all engine and the front of it was like header and pipe, and I'm not entirely sure. It was a Mengele, so I mean, weird funky Germans. I'm not entirely sure what the idea of it was, but it was a thing. And it was definitely different. Definitely different. So, my recording's just crossed the half hour mark now, so I think I'm going to leave it here for today. I'm going to continue a bit off camera, like properly off camera. But I'll leave you right now by saying, I've been Rainbow Dave, you've been watching Farming Simulator 15 on Coldborough Park Farm. Until next time, stay safe, and goodbye.